cucumbers are often grafted onto squash rootstocks. The main benefit of grafting cucumber onto squash rootstocks is to strengthen the low temperature tolerance, especially in low soil temperatures. In this video, we are going to introduce a grafting method. It is called one cotyledon or splice grafting. This method can also be used on grafting watermelons and cantaloupes. I recommend the beginning grafters try this method first. Here are the tools we use to graft cucumbers. They are the grafting clips. They are called the side grafting clips. They are different from the tube grafting clip as we use on tomatoes. It comes with different color and different shape. This is the razor blade we use to grafting. It's the same as we use on tomatoes. This is the plastic tubes we use to hold the plants after we graft it. You will see just in a minute. The first step is to cut off one of the cotyledons of rootstock. Some people may call this as seed leaves. In addition, you need to cut all the true leaves immersed. It is very important to remove the apical meristem tissue. Those are the undifferentiated cells at the base of the axillary bud. If the meristem tissue are not removed completely, rootstock shoot will grow out from here. They make outcompete scion shoots, causing dramatic reduction of yield of scion plants. Here are three rootstock plants. It's easy to tell in the first plant that axillary bud is not completely removed. Shoots of rootstocks will grow out from here. In the second plant, although there are no clear axillary bud left, it probably still have 15% chance of rootstock regrowth. The chance of rootstock regrowth would be very low for the third plant. Note the top of the cutting surface is about a few millimeters above where axillary bud grow. It is more likely that we have removed all the apical meristematic cells in the third plant. The second step of one cotyledon method is to cut the hypocotyl of scion plant in an angle similar to the cutting angle of rootstocks. Then attach the two cutting surfaces together and hold them in place with a grafting clip. It is important to keep in mind that scion and rootstock cutting surfaces must be attached tightly before they dry out, which could happen within a few minutes. With that said, it is better to finish graft one plant than start a new one. Don't cut multiple rootstocks and scions separately and then working on attaching the cutting surfaces. Ideally, it's best to graft with splice grafting method when rootstock and scion plants have similar sizes of stem diameters. However, this is not always possible. The key point is don't wait till rootstock have developed large hollow stems. After done with grafting, place a small plastic straw through the clip to provide support of the grafted plants. Don't use wooden stakes. Mold may grow on them when plants are healing under high humidity conditions. Healing grafted cucumber plants need a warm and high humidity condition.